What's up, all my worldly lovers? It's your host, Davey here, and today, welcome to the second part of a two-parter series of what I like to call The Church of Janice Burgess. And today, the time has come, I'm going to be reviewing my top five best and worst Backyardigans episodes. Now, a quick disclaimer, these are all going to be my opinions of what I think is the best and worst of these episodes. So if you agree with any of my choices or disagree, that is completely okay. These are all just going to be my opinions, okay? So just take them in with a pinch of salt. But without further ado, let's get into the countdown of the top five best and worst Backyardigans episodes. Number five, worst. Scared of You. Now, first of all, for like the first probably two or three of these worst episodes from like five to three or four, aren't necessarily bad episodes. I just find them more boring or underwhelming. Like, this episode isn't necessarily bad by any means, but it kind of feels less magical every time I watch it. I just always end up just shunning this and just kind of squirming in my seat every time I watch it. It's not necessarily bad, but just underwhelming. But there are still good things about this episode, which is why I ranked this near the bottom of my list. Well, like, top of my top five worst list. Since the songs are fun and catchy, the costume of many of these monster characters are pretty cool looking, but it's just boring and just not as magical. Even with, like, the scenario of Austin having a bad time, having, you know, the worst birthday in the world, even though these monsters were all just messing with him because they were planning a surprise birthday. And I don't know about you, but I just don't like that scenario at all. Just a character just feeling miserable by all of his peers just being assholes to him until he realized that they were all just messing with him as they actually planned out a surprise party, or they were actually going to do the things about them. Kind of reminds me of that Mickey Mouse review book that makes me think of changing that book's name to Mickey Needs New Friends. That's what I kind of think this episode should be renamed to. Austin Needs New Friends, even if they're, I don't know, imaginary. Number five, best. Cave Party. Now, I'm actually kind of surprised I put this episode this high on my list, since it's from season one, and I feel like season one is where kind of like, you know, the show is trying to find its footing, kind of like, you know, with season one of The Simpsons or even with The Muppet Show. But here we are. And yeah, this episode is really damn good. I really, really like it. So basically, the story with this episode is that Austin and you and Tasha are having a cave party on top of the mountain, since they're the mountain cave people. And Pablo, Unico, and Tyrone are the village cave people. And they send the village cave people an invitation to come to their, mountaintop so that they can have a party, so that they can howl at the moon when it's at the highest peak. You know, cave party rules. And overall, it's a really fun episode, and the songs in this episode are, in my opinion, the most unique out of any episode, since it uses a kind of unique type of music called calypso, and it really suits this episode very well, with all of the episode songs being really fun and memorable. My favorite one being the drumming song, and fun fact about that song, it's actually Tasha's singer voice's favorite song in the entire series that she's done Tasha's singing voice. And listening to it, it's a really damn fun song, and I just can't get enough of this episode. It just makes me so happy. Number four, worst. The Heart of the Jungle. Now, a lot of you might be shocked and also maybe angry of me putting this here on my list, but hear me out. As I said about the previous one, I don't necessarily think this episode is purely bad, but there are a few problems worth addressing here. First of all, the music. This is, in my opinion, the weakest out of all the Backyardigans music. Even the episode before this, that being Pirate's Treasure, even that had better music than this. I think it's pretty much just the orchestration and just kind of like the whole orchestra music background of this music. I'm just not a fan of. I mean, it would work for a show like Little Einstein, since that's a musical, orchestral show. But this is supposed to be a show with plenty of other genres, and when they do orchestral, they kind of do it the worst. And that cannot be displayed more than in one of the songs that has become one of the most popular Backyardigans songs, Into the Thick of It. I purely don't like that song for a few reasons. One, the singing is just ear-bleeding, and it's just too high. And the music is just obnoxious. Overall, this episode is not necessarily bad, it's just kind of annoying. Which is really the only thing I can say about that episode. It's just annoying. I'm sorry, but it is. Number 4. Best. The Big Dipper Diner. Now, this is another shocking episode that I put on my best list, since in season 4, I feel like that's where the show kind of loses its charm a little bit, since many of the episodes stop becoming great, and instead they just become good. But this episode is the exception. This episode is incredible. And, believe it or not, this is actually one of the highest rated Backyardigans episodes on IMDb, and I have to agree with them. It's really awesome. It's basically about Uniqua and Pablo opening up a restaurant in space called the Big Dipper Diner that they open pretty much all the time. And their regulars are actually two cops, Tyrone and Tasha, who usually come there to get their two eggs Mooney side up with star-shaped drop ketchup star shapes. And some float meal, which is oatmeal, but space, you know. But the main conflict of the episode is actually a alien that can shrink anything that it touches called the Blarg, and almost comes in and shrinks the diner, but a cute little adorable alien called Hugs stops the Blarg from shrinking the diner and basically forces the Blarg to unshrink everything. And it's all done with catchy music, as always, but the music instead is kind of like jug band music, and it suits this episode awesomely, and I just love it so much, especially Stop That Alien, which is also one of my all-time favorite Backyardigans songs. And you may or may not have seen that episode on my top 5 best and worst songs list that I did last time. But yeah, I really like this episode. It's fun, awesome, really amazing alien shrinking effects, and overall just a really fun episode. Number 3. Worst. Viking Voyage. Now, this is going to be the last of the so-called boring or mediocre type of episodes. The last two of them are definitely some of my least favorites. But this one, I wouldn't also necessarily call bad, but it's definitely more eh. And that's only because I've heard this episode so much that I've basically become numb and sick of it, because my mother loves this episode and wouldn't stop mentioning it a lot. And it just made me sick to my stomach just to hear this episode over and over and over and over again. I just became fatigued of this episode. And honestly, I just find it boring as well. It's not awful, but it's not really my favorite either. It just made me fatigued. Number 3. Best. A Giant Problem. Now, this episode, when you see it, it may not be that special, but there are several things I love about this episode that just makes it special. first of all, my biggest pro, the music. It's so awesome and catchy. Like, seriously, you could listen to every single song in this episode and it'll instantly put you in a good mood. And the singing is just so angelic, especially from Tasha's singer. Like, this is the hardest she's ever sung for this episode, and man, she sounds like an angel in this episode with two of her solo songs basically being Nobody's Bigger Than a Giant, and it's so angelic. And I also love a lot of the effects with many of the wizards' magic, like when they tried to make their hats fly on their heads, but instead they fly all over the place and go all apeshit for some reason. And they also turn into horses, and while I don't think it's aged the best, it was still ahead of its time, and they definitely did look like horses and look like their respective counterparts, with Pablo being blue and Tyrone being orangey-brown, or mainly just orange or brown, I don't know. But yeah, it's a really fun episode with tons of clever scenarios and fun moments and catchy musical numbers. It's so fun. I love it so much. Number 2, worst. Sinbad Sails Alone. Now, this might be a bit of a controversial pick, but I purely don't like this special because Sinbad is pretty much just a jerk for most of the episode, which you could say he's supposed to be a jerk, but my big issue is that by the end of the special, even with all of the stuff that he's done to Pablo, even with him saying that he is pretty second rate for a first mate, he doesn't even apologize for anything that he's done to his second mate, who basically saved his life by the end. Like, nothing. He didn't even apologize. That just baffles me for some reason. But the only reason why it's not number one is because the musical numbers, like many of the other episodes, are good as always. They're catchy, they're fun, they're creative. They're really good. But it's purely because of him not apologizing to Pablo that I have to put it this low. Number 2, best. International Super Spy. Now, a lot of you might actually be shocked to find that this is not number 1 on my list, but for good reason. But I'll get to that in a bit. First off, I want to get the positives out of the way first so I can talk about why this is not number 1. But I can definitely understand why many people call this the best. And I used to think that this was the best for a long time until I noticed a big issue in it that unfortunately had to drop it down just one spot. But it's still a really damn good episode. The characters are amazing. The tone is perfect. The visual effects for the time are really impressive. But the one thing that really sells this episode in particular is the music. The music in particular breathes this special. It mainly comprises of a lot of jazz instrumentals, which really suits this episode perfectly. Like with a spy show, you would expect this episode to be more, you know, spy music. Like, you know, that da-na-na, da-na-na, da-na-na kind of music. But this episode does a little more subtler, whatever you say. And it fits it perfectly, the jazz. I just can't imagine this episode, or this show, this episode in particular, without that jazz. Like, I can see jazz without connecting it to this episode, but I can't see this episode without connecting it to jazz. It's inseparable. It's just inseparable. Now, that one issue I was talking about, or I wasn't talking about, but I'll get to there. So the one issue that I'm saying about this episode that I think is number 2 on my list is near the very end of the episode with, like, this big climax. And on this, like, Big Ben clock, Uniqua finally opens the container to reveal chocolate syrup in which she's going to make chocolate milk as part of her evil plan. And I don't know about you guys, but I find it kind of underwhelming. And the strange thing is, many years after this, or like many episodes after this episode, there'd be another one called Robot Rampage that actually does the same thing as this episode, just in a different tone, and actually does the villain aspect of that episode a lot better. But it's not on my list just because I just personally don't think it's that great of an episode. But it's still pretty good, but definitely not top five worthy. But the reason why I particularly don't like this ending in this episode specifically, because it comes across as just very, very anticlimactic. Like, we build so much of the Lady in Pink for her to be one of the most evil villains of all time, just to find out that her evil plan is going to be chocolate milk. And that, unfortunately, is just incredibly underwhelming and just completely diddles away everything that she's going to do that's evil. And it just left me dumbfounded. And that's the reason, unfortunately, why I can't put this episode number one, is because of that ending that completely scraps and just throws everything in the garbage about Lady in Pink. It doesn't affect my overall opinion of this episode, because I still really, really like it. It's definitely in the top three, but I can't have it for number one just for that ending alone. I'm sorry, but it's the truth. But now, let's get into my number one best and worst, or worst and best. And the number one worst Backyardigans episode of all time is The Best Clowns in Town. This placement really shouldn't shock anyone because, well, this episode sucks. And did you know this is actually the lowest rated episode of Backyardigans on IMDb? And I feel like they're a little too generous for giving this a 7.1 out of 10. Yep, it's that bad. I think my biggest issue mainly with this episode is how overwhelmingly mean-spirited it is once the three clowns basically, you know, delay Ringmaster Tyrone into missing his train, because then he'll be late to his next big circus performance in a big city. And overall, it's just very, very hostile. It's not fun at all, and very, very mean-spirited. And the ending is just kind of empty. Like, the only reason why Tyrone even lets the clowns into his circus is because, well, they basically tossed him around in, like, these umbrella things while they're trying to, you know, safely land him on the ground without breaking a single bone in his body. And then he laughs out of laughter, but I am convinced that he's not laughing out of laughter. He's laughing out of fear, because he had like a terrifying experience of being thrown around by these three mutant clowns, and basically just being tortured. It's overall very hostile and very, very just messed up. It's one of the most disturbing episodes, and actually the most disturbing episode I've ever seen from the Backyardigans, and for that reason alone, I have to put it number one here, just because it's mean-spirited, hostile, and extremely sadistic. And the number one best Backyardigans episode of all time is Tale of the Mighty Knights. Now this, ladies and gentlemen, is, in my opinion, not just my number one best Backyardigans episode, but one of my favorite episodes in children's media. And I think it's just slightly better than International Super Spy. But truly, I feel like both could be interchanged based on preference. But I feel like since it doesn't have that anticlimactic scene like International Super Spy does, I feel like that makes this episode slightly better for that reason. I mean, both episodes are pretty much the equivalent of like a delicious caramel macchiato drink from Starbucks, but Tale of the Mighty Knights has basically an extra half pump of vanilla, and that's what makes it better. it's got action, it's got adventure, it's got kick-ass songs, and while the music may not be as memorable as International Super Spy, it still fits this episode incredibly well, and I still think it's iconic. And many of the songs just hit for me. All of them are straight up toe tappers. You can listen to every single song in this episode, and all of them will put you in a good mood. They are all so well done, so amazing, so incredibly catchy, and just incredible. I just love it so much. It's one of the all-time greats of Backyardigans. Actually, the all-time great of Backyardigans. And one of the greatest episodes in children's television history. I just can't get it enough. The action, the adventure, the scenarios, the songs, all of them fit and then some. And that's why I consider this episode as the number one best episode in all of Backyardigans, period. Oh, and by the way, did you know that there's actually a sequel that was made about this episode that was actually the last Backyardigans episode to ever air, ever? And I'll show you. It's called Tale of the Not-So-Nice Dragon. And my personal thoughts about this episode is, it's alright. It's not as good as Tale of the Mighty Knights, and I certainly wouldn't call it a masterpiece or a big finale to end the series, but in a weird way, that feels right. I mean, the series literally just ends with all the kids just having a tea party together. I don't know, I just find that just so cute and charming. And while not every episode is creative equally, there are still plenty of episodes that will give you a great time. And at the end of the day, that's truly what Backyardigans has given us, a great time. Backyardigans can be enjoyed by one part child and one part adult, which is why the series is always beloved by many children and many older kids, including adults. Children will love this show thanks to the colorful cast of characters, the beautiful animation, the visual effects, and many other things. And adults will like the show thanks to the sophisticated dialogue and the fun, catchy musical numbers. And this series was a huge part of my childhood, and I am so proud to have this series be a part of me and everybody else that loves this show just as much as I do too. So, Janice Burgess, from the bottom of my heart, thank you for what you've done to so many children who grow up with this series. Thanks to the colorful cast of characters, the beautiful animation, the creative scenarios, the sophisticated dialogue, the cool visual effects, and the fun, catchy musical numbers and music score. And I will be forever grateful. Rest in peace, you legend.